an actor, an accomplished puppeteer, and what you guys see is some samples of some of my comedy material, and some of my puppets. Oh, basically, kind of working for some of my friends is kind of like Gumby on steroids, because they're autistic. Oh, I got a great joke. How do you catch a unique rabbit? Unique up on it. How do you catch a tame rabbit? Tame way. Oh, basically, working for my sister is kind of like working for Mr. Magoo. Because she's not all there. And did you hear about the autistic terrorist that was hired to blow up a car? He got winded blowing in the tailpipe. Alright, and you know that stones are awfully worried? Because they were afraid that someone might take them for granted. Oh. I like this pop because it's made of wood. Reminds me where I was in work. Oakland. Anyway. My father was one of those stupid. Wouldn't he have to be one of those ex-football players? Well, he didn't know what to tell his friends because he told them all I had polio. My father's dad used to live for him. And autistic people all have brain damage. Don't you get it? Because they... Some part of their brain doesn't work right because they tend to do strange things. Like, take one autistic person. He does not know that sound travels when he gets his favorite cookie. And also, they're not smart enough to get a lookout. So you see him on his cookie and he says to his mother, "You want a cookie?" And she says, "I don't want the cookie." And he says, "Well, can I have it?" Oh, I stole that one from no one in particular. And take my friend and Wesley, an autistic Bill Cosby, because he talks about, I guess you kind of can tell I'm autistic. Take my dad, he goes like this. "Ed! Ed! Somebody will be for Eddie? Ed! Oh, boo-boo!" And Wesley's always going, This is ours. And there are some things about autistic that we're proud to inherit, and some not so proud to inherit. Like some brain damage. But enough that. I like to introduce you now to some puppets, which I'm getting out right now. You promise you won't steal my act.
Oh, I promise.
Alright, this is Bernice, and she's a... You say you won't steal my act.
What was I going to do?
You do this to me all the time, don't you have that?
I don't have any problems with that. You have any problems with that?
Well, look, if my name is on your paycheck, you don't get paid.
Uh-oh.
Alright, Parsley, what's 5 and 5? Simple as 10.
10 what?
You know, 10 anything. 10 apples, 10 oranges. he's, I don't know what this guy is. He's kind of furry. He's kind of brown. No, not light brown. You know, the same color that coffee is when you put it in the pile day, then heat it up in the microwave, then add it in the milk, and
I prefer to be thought of as beige.
Sorry.
How many monster puppets do you have?
Well, I guess I got about 8 or 9.
Hmm. How many strange beasts do you have?
3.
You go out for, send you to the Society for Prevention of Cruelty to Puppets.
What's that for short?
SPCP, Society for Prevention of Cruelty to Puppets.
You can just get away the punchline.
I'm a preacher principal. This guy tends to make a fool off himself. And again, how will you learn? The words of art and so, think that's all redundant, does fall.
Hi, Julia. I want you to say the alphabet.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, N, O, Q, R, S, T, T.
Well, you missed a letter. Where's the P?
What do you got on the legs?
You don't have any legs.
I know. I'm freelancing.
Hey, Julia Sansari. Okay, this is my friend Sansari.
How many strange beasts do you have?
Oh, I guess about 3.
How many monster pups do you have?
Oh, I guess about 8 or 9.
I will report you to the SPCP.
What's that?
Society for the Prevention of Cruelty to Puppets. Hi, this is Skip. Welcome to the JP and Dad Show. And this is a special show with JP and Dad. Woo! And now let's meet Teddy Harris.
No, it's Harris.
The boy said, Teddy Harris.
No, it's Harris. Say it correctly. Hey, ha?
Ha? This? This.
Ha?
Ha?
This?
This.
Harris.
Ha? This.
Alright. Teddy Harris.
Teddy Harris.
No, I have a new philosophy. Like that. Go over there, dead, and people will be alright. Tommy, is that you? Mom said you were a gunner. Well, I can't help wondering where all the props are for this show. They're in Bayonne, New Jersey. What's the driver doing in Bayonne, New Jersey? About 35 miles an hour. What's he doing in Bayonne, New Jersey anyway? He took a wrong turn at Mins. Oh. It's so hard to get into the healthy state, but the show must go on. Hello, this is Scientist Banner. You have been predicting some miracles and new bombs and... Well, say something scientific. E=mc². To every equal opposite reaction, there is an equal and opposite reaction. You don't need to act like a scientist. Really? You're more like a game show host. I am calling the spirits of the past. I am an angel sent by God. Oh, don't be stupid. Open your heart there, tiny Tim Ebenezer. I don't know what you're doing here. Be kind to all creatures. So Merry Christmas. You get off the line. Remember your heart to Jacob Marley. You scare me, don't you know that?
I'm saying this on the ocean and not just being huge.
So hard to find good help these days. He's a bit nervous. First time on TV. Going bananas, right? Thank you, Russell. I've been doggone about this dog. In fact, he gives me a fleas of the bees. And he's been wanting his little bone. I guess this act is going to the dogs. Now, you remind me of a famous actor.
Who? Kevin Costner?
Not that tall.
Leonardo DiCaprio?
Nope.
Phil Hartman?
He's dead.
Who?
Lassie! Evening, defenders. It's only afternoon. Can't you get your hours right? No, I'm only sleeping at this moment. It's 9 o'clock. Time to be off that fog. I'm tired to be in bed. Ooh. Now, what are some things about the life? Life is dead. Like how your business. Well, actually, it's kind of dead. Do you have anything to eat in your castle, Fangula? Would you care for a box lunch? I could possibly dig something up, and you're loyal to the gore. And that was so fresh. So tasty. So, scare me. I do that sometimes. I always wanted to clown around with this guy. And if I don't lose your head over it, somebody already did. And what a ham. And in fact, he's a good twist. Now, maybe my jokes are really that bad.
You need better material, Teddy.
And you're out there, I can hear you breathing. Two, three, four. I'm pressured. Can haunted root. Thank you, Mom. Alright. I knew this dog was so ugly, cars chased him. Oh, what did the beaver say when he heard the chainsaw? They're playing my song. Okay. This parrot is walking down through the forest. The lion staring at him. Picks up the parrot and says, your money or your 50 lives? Your money or your 50 lives? Okay. Alright. There are so many jokes I tried to tell. In fact, here's a little demonstration I like to do. Yes, Joe? All right, I will. Hey, Billy.
Yes, Jack?
Joe wants you to do a favor for him.
Where is it right now?
Can you get the hammer?
Why can't you do that right now?
Why can't you?
Because he's got the hammer in the first place.
show. Billy says you got the hammer in the first place.
Oh, okay. Here's the phone. I think I saw that.
Okay. I guess that's pretty much it. But anyway, thanks for making it do. Just a quick billboard announcement. I'll be doing a show on the arts show soon. Also, I'll be doing a show with some big guys soon. And maybe this tape will go to publication by a big name company. But I hope you liked it. Anyway, thanks for making it do. Our floor director, and for John Paul for the puppets. And you know I always say this to my mom for filming me and being supportive of me and putting it all together. And don't forget, till next time, peace on earth.